Hello, so I'm Tara Jator. I'm the treasurer of Speak Free for this year, and I'm going to be reading a poem for y'all that I wrote at one point in my life. It's called Anthologies of Boyhood or Becoming the Moon. The first is a teacher, a bright woman with skin like rice after a boil, tells a young moon the land began with a president and says he was a benevolent man, says he was good to his slaves, and for a moment, his mouth is a black hole, his heart the last, and every piece of light leaves the room, makes haste for the prim of his lips, and he swallows all this history. The second was another black boy, young, not afraid of the night, or better yet, metal was only synonym for bike or scooter, which is to say, all the black boys still smiled at the SROs. That day, the word nigga is passed around, and all the boys on the playground have no fear. History becomes a bloodless thing. I'm not sure, but I think it was a black boy who passed it to brown boy, who passed it to white boy, who did not know the shock of story, how a word sets us all blazing. He repeats until he is drunk on nostalgia, whistling, listless and sprawling like suburbs, like he can taste the blood on his lips. And suddenly it all becomes clear as Texas night, as moonrise. So how could I blame the boy for savoring memory? For even if the word is a bloodless thing, it is still rife with bone. And the moon is too comfortable with a dead thing in white boy's mouth. Even as a child, he has learned to swallow all that does not belong to him. With the word, the white boy throws him a chain marked with bodies, and black smiles, and black nods, and claps, and everything is quiet and soft, and the sun is blinding, and it too is a white thing, and the skin, paper, burning, flesh rises with soot and ash until the sun blooms white rose, and the moon is obsidian and teeming, and I understand it is a sweet thing. My father loves to chew bones after a meaty meal. I'm a ravenous boy. Blood sky. Once the moon was a young man, swallowed white, skin wiped smooth by salivating tongues. Around the circle they pass him, his body deep mahogany, hardened bright white. Moon waxes each month, becomes all the light of sky, a miracle signing among all this black. The third was the moon himself. The teacher smiles, feeds him a sweet lie, and he is bright white, grinning. A drop of blood falls from a corner of his mouth, and waning, forgets all the blood he has ever known. Yeah, thank you for listening to me do the things. Yes. So today we have with us Safia Elhillo, and she's a really, really cool person. I think she's really cool, and I've only known her for 24 hours, give or take. And so we're really, really excited to have her here for Clemming Williams. So Safia's first full-length collection, The January Children, is forthcoming from University of Nebraska Press in early 17. Sudanese by way of Washington, D.C., she received a BA from NYU's Gallatin School of Individualized Study and an MFA in poetry at the New School. She has received fellowships from Cave Canem, The Conversation, and Crescendo Literary and the Poetry Foundation's Poetry Incubator. With Fatima Asgard, she is co-editor of the anthology, Halal, If You Hear Me. Safia is an alum and former coach of the DC Youth Slam Team, the founding member of New York University's Slam NYU, and has shared her work on platforms including TEDx New York, BBC World Service, and the South African State Theater. I think she's really cool, so I'm really glad to be bringing her to the stage. Safia Elhillo.
My name is Safia. I'm much shorter than you, so one moment. And it is a real pleasure to be here. On day whatever the fuck it even is of Trump's America, I took a bubble bath and ate an apple while sitting in it today, so I'm trying to do what I can to get by. I'm also reporting live from the Muslim ban because I'm Sudanese, so. What up? It sucks. So I'm going to read some poems for you that may or may not have anything to do with that. I pledge allegiance to my homies, to my mother's small and cool hands, to the gap between my brother's front teeth, and to my grandmother's good brown hands, good, strong brown hands gathering my bare feet in her lap. I pledge allegiance to the group text. I pledge allegiance to laughter and to all the boys I have a crush on. I pledge allegiance to my spearmint plant, to my split ends, to my grandfather's brain and gray left eye. I come from two failed countries, and I give them back. I pledge allegiance to no land, no border cut by force to draw blood. I pledge allegiance to no government, no collection of white men carving up the map with their pens. I choose the table at the Waffle House with all my loved ones crowded into the booth. I choose the shining dark of our faces through a thin sheet of smoke, glowing dark of our faces slick under layers of sweat. I choose the world we make with our living, refusing to be unmade by what surrounds us. I choose us gathered at the lakeside, the light glinting off the water and our laughing teeth, and along the living dark of our hair. And this is my only country. Fact. The Arabic word hawa means wind. The Arabic word hawa means love. Test, multiple choice. Abd al-Halim said, you left me holding wind in my hands. Or Abd al-Halim said, you left me holding love in my hands. Abd al-Halim was left empty, or Abd al-Halim was left full. Fairuz said, O wind, take me to my country. Or Fairuz said, O love, take me to my country. Fairuz is looking for vehicle, or Fairuz is looking for fuel. Kulthum said, where the wind stops her ships, we stop ours. Or Kulthum said, where love stops her ships, we stop ours. Kulthum is stuck, or Kulthum is home. Did our mothers invent loneliness? Or did it make them our mothers? Were we fathered by silence or just looking to explain away this gaping quiet? Is it wasteful or wistful to pray for our brothers in a language they never learned? Whose daughters are we if we grow old before our mothers or for their sakes? They called our grandfathers the January children, lined up by the colonizer and assigned birth years by height. There is no answer because we come from men who do not know when they were born, who married women shown to them in photographs, whose children left the country and tried for romance and had daughters full of all the wrong language. And at the musicians' club in Umdurman, a singer is stabbed to death for playing secular music. The month before, a violinist on his way home is beaten by police, his instrument smashed to matchwood. All the bars in Khartoum are closed down. All the alcohol in Khartoum poured into the Nile. A new law forbids women from dancing in the presence of men. Another bans song lyrics that mention women's bodies. And at a party in Umdurman, lights strung among the date palms, my not yet mother, honey legs in a skirt, opens her mouth and the night air is the gap in her teeth. She sings in a lilting English to a slow song while bodies around her pair off and press close. Before he is my father smokes a cigarette and shows all his teeth when he laughs, wants to ask the dark gold girl how her English got so good, what the words mean, could he sing something sometime into the gap in her teeth. But first, police arrive, rip lanterns from trees and fire a shot through the final notes of the song, and tonight, my parents do not meet. But I imagine Khartoum as it was in the 80s, my mother with ribbons in her hair, dress fanning about her nutmeg calves, my father, who I hear was so lively and handsome that only bad magic could have emptied that and filled him with smoke, the borrowed record player, the generation that would leave to make nostalgia of these nights, to hyphenate their children and grow gnarled by diasporas every winter. But tonight, Motown crackling in the hot twilight, mosquitoes swaying in the velvet dusk, my parents dance without ever touching. And now my mother harbors her country's music in her lungs, these songs the only things she got in the divorce. There is a TV show we used to watch when we lived in Egypt, where a group of Sudanese youth sing old Sudani love songs. We don't get the channel here in the US. Tonight, my mother finds every episode on YouTube. After a quiet dinner of leftovers at the kitchen counter, because it's just us two, my brother is out being 22 and popular. My mother and I sit together in the half light, and eat mango with our hands and listen to Asim al-Banna sing Fit-Tayf, and I never hear love songs like this in English. Songs that are as much about a country as they are about a woman. Songs where woman is country. Before we grew bitter and learned not to make a world out of a person, learned not to make a world out of a country, because even your mother's country can betray you. My mother's country broke her heart and I want to cry, picturing her eating mango alone in the dark, singing to herself. My brother and I, a world away, with our fast English and our hip hop and our late nights, we are not from a world where love songs are like this. We are not romantic. We are not considerate. We forget to call. We do not bother to phone the cable people to ask for the channel with my mother's favorite show. We do not bother to teach her how to bookmark videos on YouTube, how to download all the old love songs into her iTunes, how to buy mango already sliced, packaged in neat plastic tubs. But the story goes, my father would never unwrap a piece of gum without saving half from my mother. The story goes, my mother saved all the halves in a jar. That's not the point. I'm not looking for anything serious, just someone to watch my plants when I'm gone. You can sing now if you want to. They're worried no one will marry me. I have an accent in every language. I want to be left alone, but that's not how you make grandchildren. I can't go home with you. Home is a place in time. That's not how you get me to dance. I'm not from here. I'm not from anywhere. I mean to say that I don't know that song. I mean to say that my body is a pill, small, and love is the wrong man's tongue to tell me so. My body dissolves. My body finds men who are water and calls them home. My body is everything that happened to me. Love is a thing my body borrows to forget. Love is a pill. My body is water. My body is a tongue and love dissolves. Love calls the wrong man home. Love makes my body a stain and goes looking for water on the wrong man's tongue. Love is a house. My body is a bath drawn in floodwater. My body trickles in through the floorboards. Love is the carpet that I've ruined. Love is decoration. Love is an alternative to water. Love is just something to do until the wars start. My body is a border drawn up by some man long ago. Love is everything that happened in between. Love is the floorboards. My body is decoration. Love ruined all the carpets. My body is the carpet. My body is the stain. Love makes it all dissolve. Love is an alternative to home. Love is floodwater. My body burned to the ground. My body called the wrong man home. Love started the fire. My body is everything that happened after. The wrong man is an alternative to love. The wrong man is a map. Home is where he puts the lines. My body is a border drawn by accident, by the wrong man's tongue. Love makes scars on my body and calls them borders. The wrong man mistakes my body for a body of water. Love let the wrong man decide what my body mistakes for home. Love started the fire. My body is a house on fire. My body drew a bath in flood water. The wrong man is flood water. Love and the wrong man are an alternative to hating my body. My body is a body of water, poured over everything that happened to me. My body makes every scar an island. The wrong man makes my body small, a pill. Love makes the water, and my body dissolves. And in the orange Khartoum summer, I am gathered with my cousins in the alley, blinking away the flies. Nadia, at 15, is the eldest and has a boyfriend, who takes her in a borrowed car to the Corniche by the Nile and is not allowed to touch her, because kissing a boy with tongue will make you pregnant. I am 12 years old, and months later, I see first blood, thinking it a miscarriage. And once, we lived in Zamalek in the same building as Muhammad Tharwat. Once, I was 4 years old in Dar es Salaam in love with a boy named Osmani. Once, in Sharm el Sheikh, I bought a peach-colored doll and was called Dark Girl for the first time. Smiled with my teeth, didn't know he meant to be cruel. Once, in Cairo, I sat next to Amr Diab's daughter while learning to embroider nameless and tiny flowers. Once, in Nairobi, I learned to speak English. Once, in Washington, D.C., I answered black and was told to say nigger to prove it. Once, in Khartoum, I was 3 days returned, not yet readjusted, and wearing bright white sneakers that I cleaned with a toothbrush once in Khartoum. The sun warmed my earrings until I had to take them out once in Geneva. The pink wall took the skin off my arm once in Geneva. I was one of three African girls at school, two of which were said to stink. I was never told which two. So I understand why you didn't call me back. I peel and peel and cannot undress. I wear my grandfather and my left eye turns to milk. My grandmother and the curl unravels from my hair. I smell a flower and dill and acidic perfume. I wear my mother and remember a garden with magnolia flowers. A scarf packs up my heavy hair. I wear my brother and a bullet is assigned me at birth. I wear blood in my mouth, where a man's name or a language should be. And now the lyrics do not translate. Arabic is all verbs for what stays still in other languages. Tasbah, to morning, what the translation to awake cannot honor, cannot contain its rhyme with tasbah, to swim, to make the night a body of water. I am here now and I am not buoyant. I am 26 and always sick, small for my age and always translating. I cannot sleep through the night. No language has given me the rhyme between ocean and wound that I know to be true. Sometimes, when the doctors draw my blood, I feel the word at the edge of my tongue. Halim sings, aghraq, aghraq. I am drowning, I am drowning. The single word for all the water in his throat does not translate. Halim sings, teach me to kill the tear in its duct. Halim sings, I have no experience in love, nor have I a boat. And I know he cannot rest, cannot swim through the night. I am looking for a voice with a wound in it. A man who could only have died by a form of drowning. Let the song take its time. Let the ocean close back up. Alternate ending. The dead boy is poured back into his body. I try to leave home, but the ocean bares its teeth. And where I'm from is where I'm from and not where I was put. It's morning, and my grandmother pins hot colors to the clothesline. It's evening, I'm on a date, and the words, say something to me in Arabic, fall backwards down his throat. And what is a country but the drawing of a line? Today I draw thick black lines around my eyes and they are a country. And thick red lines around my lips and they are a country. And the knife that chops the onions draws a smooth line through my finger and that is a country. And the tightening denim presses a soft purple line into my belly. And when I smile like my mother, a line flashes between my two front teeth. And for every country I lose, I make another and I make another. And so, I believe that we do not die. I will not believe that to be housed in a body that is black is to be always dressed in black for the funeral. We live forever. Sometimes our mouths open and a song falls out, thick with a saxophone syrup, and all our dead in the ground make this land ours, and all our missing fathers make us everything's child. Today I did not dress for a funeral. That's funny because I'm wearing black. Today I did not dress for a funeral. Today I wear the yellow dress and laugh with all my teeth. Today my lost ones are not lost to me. They live in the wind that gathers my skirt. Today this is my country. Today I say their names in all the holes left behind, shaped like black girls and black boys are lit up by hundreds of faraway stars. Today I woke up and was not dead. And tomorrow might be different, but tomorrow does not yet exist. So I hold my mother's hand and kiss the brown valley between each knuckle. My brother opens his mouth to laugh and the light pours in through the gap in his teeth. I press my body to a man that I find beautiful and sway to a song that knows us. I live forever with my feet in my grandmother's lap. I live forever by the water with the sun spilled over me. Remember me this way. And when they come for me, play the song I love into the space I leave behind. So those poems were from a project called Alien Suite, and to do a product plug, I have chapbooks to sell and I do accept credit card. if you want to come talk to me after the show. And this next suite of poems is newer, about a boy. And each poem is named after one of the five prayers in the Muslim day. Because we were both Muslim, I thought it would be funny, but it ended up just being really sad. So, Fajr, New York City. The philosopher turns in his sleep, dark hair a cursive on the pillowcase, and I want to unlatch my body from its own sinking and love him back. Later, he tells me he loves my sadness, and instead of saying, "That's not me, I'm here somewhere behind it," I pretend instead to be asleep. His particular smell of pomegranates and smoke unlatches from his body to visit me at night, years later in a city we do not share. His city burns on the news and I mean to call him, but he has since sealed up the wound belonging to my name. I miss him when I sit in airplanes. I miss him when an orange spark latches itself to a coal. I sit inside my small and unsaved life, and his haunting guards me carefully while I float in and out of sleep. Subh, New York City. Cool dark of the morning to quiet my leaving. I feel the love of one I thought braided eternal to my life leave my body through a cut on my palm and rush to fill some other girl, some fuller and more solid girl, and I am left behind. Because he is kind, I cannot hate him. And her I try to hate but fail. I see them photographed together and she is almost me, one of my parallel selves washed clean of all that makes me hard to love, a sunlit girl built to last, freeing him from my dark and jungled bed. Dhuhr, New York City. And in the light, the facts go damp around their borders. It was my fault. I said leave and meant help, but I said leave. And when you left, I slept a full necklace of days, woke convinced the blood had gone solid in my legs. You'd quote Darwish like I now know all men without countries do, but in those days, I thought my particular wounds monogamous and only mine, fell in love with our corresponding aches. Both of us just Muslim enough that in the mornings when you woke to find me, sobbing into the velvet of the prayer, you kept quiet and took it for the usual set of guilts. Smoke drifting through our loosened hair, sunlight quieting to listen with us to the crackling al-balabil song that made me cry with you and doesn't anymore. Asr, New York City. I am not yours, I am a bruise, shallow dark filled with blood beneath the skin's weak border. But I wanted to be good, a girl who could count among her victories leaving bed every day. Still, I wake late afternoon from a dream weighted by your far away and blurring face, your hair shot through with amber in the light, first haunting in months, the wound an unlocking door, and I miss you as mine more than I am happy that you are happy, that you forgot me and my teething silence, and in the dream we had a daughter and we named her for an island, and the dream is not you, it will not leave when I say leave. Maghrib, New York City. This was going to be Sestina, and then I got to five stanzas and ran out of things to say, so I don't know formally what that makes it. Maghrib, New York City. The day ends, and I kneel crookedly in the half light, wiping black coal from my eyelids. I snake my hair to little braids, slick with oil, and more oil to kiss away the red caked onto my mouth. I gleam into the bathroom mirror, cool water in my hands. Outside, it is dark, and I want to say his name. A woman died to give me mine. Without her, what could I name myself? Which do I know in all my half languages? My parallel life lived back across the water. He too was this way. World broken by oceans, an island remapped. The quiet parts where language fails in the mouth. I was a darkness in his bed, sunless and shining like oil. Forgive the way I know the world to be, broken by oceans and oil. Forgive the way I crowd my quieter hurts and give them all his name. He'd go silent gathering smoke, burning village in his mouth. What sort of country could we have been, combining our half homes, our shared forgetting, a life spent mostly behind eyelids. The plants he brought would die. It was dark. I would drink all the water. And what of the illness we didn't share? The blood thin as water sliding around inside my body. I lived alone in fever, sweat, and oil, turning the bed sheets a blacker blue. My better selves pressed against my eyelids and waited their turn to love him, practice the smoke taste of his name. He wasn't mine, and I belonged only to my silence, to my half-sleep. I wake in the dark craving fruit, taut skin pressed to my cracked mouth. If I wake a different girl, would he know me by my mouth or at all? Would he learn my new body, alive like boiling water? The loud and fluent language that in my dreams I always have. I'd make a new heart, fresh in butcher paper, fried in onions and bright oil. And what if I had a country? What then would be my name? And the plants would stay alive, the spearmint, the violets. Aisha, New York City. 1. I write a poem about my heart and lie on my back at night, listening to its wet beat, its little ache, and I am convinced it will soon stop beating out of spite. 2. I leave for days to sit inside the color blue, the translucent skin at his wrists and the smoke we sent twisting into the flat black night. 3. He leaves and I file down to my raw pink beginning. I give my name back to the dead woman. I descend a line of blood and find others who belong only to our own dark and copper taste. 4. We outlive our particular beauties, and then. So I choose another. I choose blue music, hookah smoke unspooling from our mouths. I want him to know I am not lonely. I have ghosts, I have my illnesses, I have a mouthful of half languages and blood thick with medication. Doctors line up to hear my crooked heart. Some weekends I dance. Sometimes I go missing. I fry eggplant. I listen to his stories that are my stories. Dead boys, burned cities, ache older than our bodies, our homes that are not our homes. Most days I feel I am walking through water. Most days I forget the sound of my voice, and he tries to kiss me goodnight. Thank you. So if you want to, you know, buy some merch, I have chapbooks, I have postcards. Usually I have more chapbooks, but, you know, the suitcase was small this time. But thank you so much for having me.